All right, as I said, welcome. I'm glad you all were able to join me this morning. Just wanted to have a time of worship, spend some time worshiping the Lord, and I wanted to invite you all to join me this morning for that. As you know, we get into this, I want to pray first. There are a couple of friends of mine that I know who is ill right now, one of my good friends. And actually, she's spoken here for our ministry when we were in Ohio. Name is Pam Waugh, and her two daughters are actually well, one just had a tooth pull, and the other one is, I believe, 8 months pregnant and is ill right now. And so we just want to pray for them. Just speak life for them this morning. Then I want to just share something with you that the Lord told me this morning as I was coming back to the house here. Father, we just love you. We just thank you for another opportunity to come together as a family and to relax and just enjoy the presence of God. And Father, we love you today, God. We just thank you, Lord, for keeping us safe, Lord God. And Father, I thank you for those who are able to stay home today because of the weather and be able to kind of just relax with their family, with their loved ones, God. And Lord, I just thank you today, God, that you are faithful, Lord. Yes, Lord, you're so faithful, Lord, and you will continue to be faithful, God. And Lord, we just love you with all our hearts, God. And Father, as we just kind of just snuggle in today, we want to spend time with you as we are, like, you know, sitting by the fire, you know, sitting at your feet, just anticipating, waiting to hear what you have to say. And so, Lord, we just thank you, God, for just being here with us right now and just this time of just to worship you, Lord. And we just love you for it. And we thank you, God, that as we worship you, Lord God, as we kiss you, you kiss us back. As we embrace you, you embrace us back, God. And so, God, we are this is something that is this tangible, God, that we can feel your presence, Lord. And when you release, you know, things in our lives, we can feel it. And so, Lord, I just ask you, God, for and I bless my friends who are watching today. Father, I just ask you, God, that you would just release something today, God, that they have been waiting on, God. I pray today that, Lord, that you begin to speak something, Lord God, through this time of worship. That nobody could have known, Lord God, but you and them. And so, Lord, we just bless you for it now. Now, I pray for my friend Pam and her two daughters, God. Father, we just speak the healing power of God right now, and we send forth the angels right now to Ohio. Yes, Lord, and to where her daughters are right now. Father, we pray for Pam, who is in Ohio, God. We pray for her daughters, Lord. Father, we just release the healing of God to them right now in Jesus' mighty name. And Father, we decree and declare, Lord God, that they are healed now. Father, you sent forth your word, and they were healed. And so, Father, we send the word now. Yes, Lord, we send the word. In Jesus' mighty name, we declare healing now to their bodies. Yes, Lord, in Jesus' mighty name, we thank you for covering the baby. We thank you for keeping the baby protected and safe, God. Father, I thank you, God, that no weapon formed against them shall prosper, God. And we decree that today in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. All right. Well, listen, as we get into this, I was coming back from dropping off my wife, and those of you, you know, who are here in the St. Louis area, you know, we got, you know, dumped off with some snow And it's funny because I found out that it's actually even worse as you go towards the city. they actually got more snow than the county did. As I was coming back, and I was just kind of just taking my time, I was looking at the cars behind me on my, you know, my rearview mirror. And I heard the Lord saying to me, he said, don't worry about the cars behind you. Just stay focused on what's before you. All right. He said, just pay attention to what's in front of you. And don't worry about what's going on behind you. And so, I'm driving as he says that. And I'm like, man, I said, that's a word, that's a word, Lord. And just really just hit my spirit that in life and just in everything that we're doing, we just need to stay focused and just look ahead. Okay. And I noticed something that even when I was looking and checking out the cars behind me to see, how close they were or how far, that for a split second, it took my focus off of what was in front of me, okay? And so although there was no cars in front of me, there was snow on the ground, okay, which I had to pay attention to because, some spots were clear, some spots wasn't. And so the Lord said that to me. And so in life, as we walk in this journey, that I believe that it's necessary, and even now, that we stay focused, that we stay focused on what is ahead and not what is behind. The things behind us can take our focus off of what God is doing right before our eyes. Okay, we can be so focused on what is going on behind us that we miss what is happening in front of us. And so that's really a precious tool and a principle from the Lord to stay focused. Paul said that. He said, one thing I do, he said, I have not, I'm not saying that I have attained or I have arrived. He said, but this one thing I do, and that's powerful to me, just the tone of Paul's statement right there. That it was a tone of this, I haven't mastered everything, but this one thing that I've learned, this one thing I do, this one thing that I practice, that I put in motion in my life, I forget those things which are behind me, okay? And I reach towards the things which are before me, okay? And so very important that we forget those things which are behind. Okay, whatever's going on behind will take care of itself, all right? A lot of times people want to try to bring you back or try to pull you back to what used to happen or watch this now or where they are, okay? Spiritually speaking, some want to pull you where they are, all right? But it is necessary for your spiritual walk and theirs that you continue to move forward, okay? You forget what is behind you. Now, that may sound kind of cold as it relates to people that we know, but it's not, because only God, when we speak of spiritual levels in Him, it is God's responsibility to take care of those who are on level one or level two, okay? Now, a lot of times God will have you to turn around and speak life, okay? But there are times where God will tell you, I want you to stay focused. Stop worrying about them, okay? And, many of you right now, you feel as though that you got to do everything. You got to save everybody, okay? You got to be someone's rescuer, and particularly in your family. They look to you for the answers. They look to you to come through, okay? But I believe right now in this season that God is wanting to do something for your families that does not involve you. In other words, that it is time now for them to see God. Okay, and I feel in my spirit that is a word for someone, that it is time for them to see God, and they can't see Him if you're in the way. They can't see him if you continue to come in and rescue them, okay? In order for them to really see God, in order for them, for their faith to grow, all right? In order for them, their faith to grow, it is necessary for you to stay out of it. And so many, and I see this by the Spirit here, that many have, I see some individuals, you know, and some specifically some couples who have got into it over this matter, okay? One says, well, you know, and this relates to money. And it's like, you know, we're always bailing them out, okay? We're always sending money back to them. We're, you know, and, you know, you got one person, well, that's my family. You know, we look out for each other and all of that. And so, but you got one saying, well, no, you know, we can't do it, you know, and it's caused division now in the house. And so for that particular one, somebody else or someone who needs to grow, all right, is causing division in your own home because you won't step back and take your hands off of it. And so I just really just hear the Lord saying, you need to stay focused. You need to stay focused. You need to allow them to see God for themselves. It's time for that now. For the sake of your marriage, for the sake of your spiritual walk, you need to allow them to see God. Okay? And so now I don't know why, you know, I was saying all that, that part. Okay? I just sense that someone needs to hear that. But it is necessary. It is necessary. Okay? You have done enough. You have done, you know, in times past, you have, like, really, you know, done things that come through. But now it's time for them to see God for themselves, okay? It's time for them to start believing God. It's time for them to start, it's time for them to start trusting God, okay? And so one of the things we don't want to do is, we don't want to be the Uriah in their lives. Excuse me, not Uriah, but King Uzziah. We don't want to be King Uzziah in their lives. Isaiah said that. When King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord. Okay? King Uzziah wasn't a bad king, but in order for Isaiah to see the Lord, Uzziah had to be moved out of the way. Okay? And so that's just a principle that God wants you to move forward in the things that he has for you, okay? And you can become a Uzziah in someone's life that is preventing them from seeing the Lord and not stopping them from growing. It's just like a flower that needs the sun, okay? And you and I standing in front of the sun trying to protect or be the shade for that flower. Well, in order for that flower to grow, it needs the sun, which means you need to move out of the way, okay? And so God was just really just saying that, you know, that we really need to stay for, you know, that we need to focus on what is God speaking to me. God is going to take care of them. God is big enough and smart enough and knows exactly where they are. Now, God, what are you speaking to me? What are you speaking to my house? What is it that you're called for us to do? And so I believe it's very important. I believe it's very important that we grab a hold of that. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Okay, listen, there's a chat room right below the screen of our website there. Feel free to use that. Now, it may ask you for to create a username, a login. Just go ahead and do that. You're not, you know, signing up for anything, but it just gives you access to be able to chat through the chat room there, okay? And so I'm watching it right now. I'm looking at it right now. So if at any moment or any time that if our audio is too low or you're not able to hear us or whatever, you know, this is why we kind of monitor that so we can make the adjustments and all that good stuff, okay? So just relax and just let's just enjoy the presence of the Lord, okay? And just see what the Lord has to say. Holy Spirit. We welcome you. Holy Spirit, have your way. Holy Spirit, we welcome you so have your way today. Holy Spirit, we welcome you, Holy Spirit, have your way. Holy Spirit, we welcome you, so have your way. Worship Him, worship Him, worship Him, worship Him. With all your heart, with all your heart, oh, worship Him. Oh, worship Him. With all your heart, with all your heart, with all your heart, worship Him. I bow at your feet. I bow at your feet and give you my best. I give you my best. Your feet, I bow at your feet and give you my best. I give you my. my best. Worship. I give you my best. I give you my best. There's a peace that is being released right now. I just heard the Lord saying that there's a peace that's being released as we're just focusing on Him and worshiping Him. There's a peace. There's a peace in this place. There's a peace in this place. Reach out and grab it. It's for you. There's a peace. Place, there's a peace in this place. Reach out and grab it, it's for you. This peace comes, thank you, Lord, to calm the storms. This peace comes to quiet the noise. Reach out and grab it. It's for you. From the Father. Oh, he says, reach out and grab it. It's for you. Today. You'll never be the same. No, no. You'll never be the same. You'll never be the same. No, no. You'll never be the same. Come on, you sing that. I'll never be the same, no, no. I'll never be the same, yeah. Come on, you say that. I'll never be the same, no, no. I'll never be the same. Come on, I'll never be the same. I'll never be the same, no, no. I'll never be the same. Hallelujah. I'll never be the same, no, no. I'll never be the same. I'll never be the same. I'll never be the same. Yes. When the peace of God comes, when the peace of God is released, change happens. Your life will never be the same. This peace comes to set things in order. This peace comes to quiet the storm. This peace comes to destroy and diffuse the chaos. I receive your peace, God. I receive your peace, God. I receive your peace, God, yeah. I hear the Lord saying, that's all you need. Just my peace. That's all you need. Oh, just my peace. Thank you, Jesus. You know, there's this, I've sung this song, one particular song here, plenty of times. It's a song by my good friend Mark Kinney. And it just simply says, let's enjoy the presence. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's do it right now. Let's enjoy the presence of the Lord. See, when you have that peace, when you have that peace, you can just enjoy the presence of the Lord. You know, chaos comes to take away your joy. My wife and I this week had an encounter with God, literally had an encounter with God this week. We were, I had stepped out of the bedroom and, because I told her, I said, hey, you know, I'm finna go watch the game. And, you know, the show, the game, right? And so I'm watching it, And I hear this music coming out of our bedroom, and I knew she was on the laptop. And so she comes in, peeks in the room. Me and my daughter were watching the game. She comes, peeks in. She says, "Okay, well, I'm going back to my praise party." And so when the show was over, I went into the bedroom, and she was like just done. and so I was messing with her. She's like, no, you got to see this. You got to see this. And it was a video of Karen Clark Sheard sharing her testimony about what happened to her. And just in essence, she was just saying that, you know, it's time out for looking cute and praise. You know, she was talking about the power of praise and all of that. It just triggered something in his house. Well, before that, all of that happening, I was listening to an audio from 2008 that I hadn't heard in a good while from when I was in Ohio, and we were at Living Word Worship Center. And my good friends, my buddy, Apostle CJ and Lanita Gall, we were all doing worship, and Lanita gave this word about being prepared for the suddenlies, being prepared for the Lord coming to his temple. You know, Malachi says that, okay, that the Lord was coming to his temple. He was sending his messenger, and he was coming to his temple suddenly. And that was the word. And it just really just hit me. I said, wow, you know, we have to be prepared for the suddenlies of God, okay? And so I'm listening to this word. I'm like, wow, this is around time. Well, fast forward now to where we watch this video with Karen, I begin to see the connection now, the connection with what Lanita was saying, and then Karen was saying pretty much the same thing about the suddenlies and, you know, releasing praise and all of that and expectation. Well, the Lord was not done. So then my wife goes on and looks at another video of Beverly Crawford. Now, these are old videos now on YouTube. And she's just talking about expectation. And she was saying, you know, mine is coming next. You know what, you know, what God has for me is, you know, it's my turn. It's coming next. And she was talking about, I'm looking for it, you know, expectation, right? She was flowing expectation. And I kid you not, that we begin to pray in that moment, the Spirit of God just like, boom, I mean, just hit us. We both were in tears, releasing praises to the Lord. Well, that this past Monday, God was sharing some things with me about my own family, and I shared it with her, and it was like just, you know, it was just a God moment where God came suddenly, all right? And so now after all of that happened now, we began to watch some other videos. Now, running into some videos, her, you know, she was just kind of just going, she was like, well, going to different videos. She's like, okay, well, let's watch this. Start listening, watching other videos, and turns out they start saying the same thing. Just, I mean, it all started lining up. And I said, girl, your hand is anointed tonight, you know, but it was God, you know. But my point is this. You know, the things will come to try to take away your peace and try to take away your joy. But God says, just enjoy my presence. He said, let's do it right now. You know, it hasn't happened yet. It is on its way. God says that, and we talked about this, about how there are things that have manifested. There are things that have manifested, and it's on its way. Hallelujah. So let's just enjoy the presence. Let's just enjoy the presence. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's do it right now. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's do it right now. Watch this. What are you waiting for? What are you waiting for? What are you waiting for? Let's do it right now. What are you waiting for? What are you waiting for? What are you waiting for? Let's do it right now. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's do it right now. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's do it right now. Now this is the gist of this song. That no matter what you're waiting on, no matter what, you know, the word is, it's been spoken over your life, you don't have to wait for it to show up to then to release a praise to God. All right? You don't have to wait to see it to say, yay, God. No. You go ahead and say that now because you got a word. Oh, God. Because, see, you're just like Jeremiah because you already saw it. Oh, God, I hope you hear me. You already saw the word, the word that's going to be performed. Oh, catch that. You already saw the word that's going to be performed. Mm-hmm. So, in other words, you don't have to see it yet to say hallelujah. You don't have to see it yet to begin to release a praise to God. Oh, God, you already seen it in the spirit, and you already know that it's going to be performed. So I don't care if it's a victory. I don't care if it's a healing that needs to happen. I don't care if it's some type of vindication that needs to happen. You already seen it. And he says, my word, that thing that you saw, I'm going to perform that. So now we can just enjoy the presence. Come on. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's do it right now. Come on. What are you waiting for? What are you waiting for? What are you waiting for? Let's do it right now. Come on. What are you waiting for? What are you waiting for? What are you waiting for? Let's do it right now. Oh, let's enjoy the presence. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's do it right now. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's do it right now. Come on. Come on, right in front of your computer screen. Right in front of your computer. Come on, just get up and give praise to God. Come on, get up and give him a dance. Get up and just begin to leap. My God, oh God, because you already seen it. Hey, you already seen it. You already seen it. God says, this is the reason why I gave you the day off today. He says, I scheduled a praise break for you. You have prayed long enough. You have even declared long enough. He says, so now you need to kick in with the praise. Yeah.
See, I got this picture right now. I see the vision, a vision of a cake. And the cake is already made now, okay? It's already been taken out of the oven and it's had a time to cool off. And the last thing that needs to be put on that cake is the icing. Uh-huh. So before you can enjoy this cake here, yes, you got to put some icing on it. That's the last thing that needs to happen. Well, you prayed enough. You declared enough. Now ice that thing with your praise. Come on. You've prayed enough. You even declared enough. Now ice that thing with your praise. Come on. That's your cue. That's your cue to begin to stand and just begin to leap. Come on, ice that thing. Come on. With your praise. Come on. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's do it right now. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's enjoy the presence. Let's do it right now. Come on, are you icing it? Come on, the cake is already made. Are you icing it? Man, my God. I hear God saying that many of you ask the Lord, God, what else is there I need to do? You know, what else do I need to do now? And he said, this is it. And it almost like kind of startled you. Because you have been in this place of, it's like a disbelief. You're like, God, is that it? Because see, you've been used to praying over it. You've been used to like making declarations over it. And God says, you've done enough of that. Now, what I want you to do is I want you to praise me. You don't understand what your praise does. Your praise, watch this now. Your praise now puts the last bit. It's the finale. It's the finale on what is about to happen. It is through your praise that you also give thanksgiving. All right. It's your praise is the finale of things. He says your praise is the last thing that you needed to do. Your praise is the last thing that you needed to do. This is the reason why the enemy hit you the way he did. This is the reason why the enemy didn't like you releasing the praise. Because it was through the praise where you begin to exalt God for what he's done, what he's doing, okay, and what he's going to do. So it was the last thing that you had to do there. It was the very last thing that you had to do. Come on. Come on, just release your praise now to God. Come on, I feel this. Come on, just release it now. I hear God saying, release the praise now. You put the finale. It's the finale. It's the final thing that you have to do. My God, I'm telling you, I really do hear this. Many of you, God literally gave you the day off so you could put the final touch on this thing that you've been praying about. Because, see, you can really praise God like you wanted to at work. So he gave you a day off so you can, like, finalize this thing. And he said, it's all you need to do is just do praise, just declare it. Oh, God. When you praise God, you're declaring or you're making known his deeds. You understand? The Bible says that to make his deeds known. It's another translation. The way it says it's almost like it's headline news. Okay, it's like the front of a newspaper. You are writing the story, and God is giving you the front page of the newspaper to declare his praises. And he said, it's the last thing that you need to do. Because you've asked people to pray with you. You've asked people, you know what I'm saying, to believe God. Oh, God, to believe God with you. But now God says, all you need to do now is just praise me. Just enjoy my presence. Just begin to see it coming in. Ah, God, begin to see it coming in. See it coming in. I got a boast. See it coming in. I just keep saying it because I believe that we need to hear that today. See it coming in. Oh, hey, see it coming in. I hear him saying that. Come on. See it coming in. See it coming in. See it coming in. Come on, release it. See it coming in. See it coming in. See it coming in. I hear God saying, your victory is now. 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 Come on, see it coming in. See it coming in, yeah. See it coming in, hey. See it coming in right now, yeah. Come on, see that coming in. See it coming in. See it coming in. See it coming in right now. Come on, see the healing coming in right now. See the deliverance coming in right now. Come on. If you know how to pray in the spirit, please just pray in the spirit right now. I hear the Lord saying to someone that you're coming out of the dark place. The place that you live, the place that you're staying in is a dark place. And I hear the Father saying right now, you're coming out of the dark place. 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 Come on, keep praying. Come on, you're coming out of the dark place. You're coming out of the dark place. Hey, and the dark spaces. You're coming out of the dark places and the dark spaces. You're coming out. He says he has not forgotten you. He said he has not forgotten you. He said he has not ignored your cry. For the Lord says that he said, I want you to put your focus on the things that I have for you. He said, I want you to take your focus now off of what was. He said, I want you to put your focus on what is. And the Spirit of the Living God says, I'm bringing you out of the dark places and the dark spaces into the light. Shekananana. And you shall not die, but you shall live. Come on, keep praying. I see someone that the Lord called you away. He called you to a place, a time with him. And the Spirit of the Living God says, this is the day. This is the day. This is the day that I anoint you. This is the day that I come upon you. This is the day that I clothe you. This is the day that I smear you with the anointing oil. This is the day that I release upon you my presence. And this is the day that I release upon you my jewels. You're beginning to see right now some things manifest right before your eyes right now. The goodness of God. Oh, that's God. Oh, sing that with me. Oh, yeah. Come on, that's a war cry. That's a war cry. That's a war cry. That's a war cry. The Father said, victory is imminent. Prepare for victory. Prepare. Make room. Make room now. Make room. Make room. Make room in your house. Make room in your bank accounts. Make room. Make room. Make room. Make room. That someone you have been believing God for a baby. God says, make room. He says, go ahead now and get the room ready. Go ahead and remodel, change around, adjust, make the room ready in preparation for the child. But you have said, God, I'm not showing yet. Shaka. God says, yes, yes. God says, you said, I'm not showing yet, God. But I hear the Spirit of the Lord saying to you right now. He says, go check again. I just hear the Lord saying right now, go check again. And you know what that means. He says, go check again. Yeah. You have taken pregnancy tests. You have taken a pregnancy test. Excuse me. You have taken a pregnancy test over and over. And it kept showing up negative. But God says to you, Hannah, you have been laying on the altar. He says, go check again. Go check again. Go check again. And he says, after you check, start preparing now. Shakata. Start preparing now. Oh, start preparing now. I hear the Lord saying right now to a pastor, start preparing now. He says, start preparing now. Get your people ready to move. Get your people ready to move. Handa hasaka for the letabo, for the land, for the property that you have been spying out. The Spirit of Almighty God says, get ready to move into it. Start packing up now. Get the stuff together now. For the land that you have spied out, for the land that you have seen, God says, you're getting ready to move into it. For you said, God is gone. For you have said, God, I don't have it anymore. God, it's gone. Someone else has it now. But the Spirit of Almighty God says, go, 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 go and prepare. Go and prepare. Get your people ready. Go and prepare. What you were going to talk about Sunday, change it up. I hear God saying, he says, your message for this Sunday coming up is to tell the people to make themselves ready to move. Come on, if I were you, I would just catch it. If I were you, I would just catch it. If I were you, I would just catch it. If I were you, I would just catch it. Come on, worship him. Come on, worship him. Come on, worship him. Come on, and worship him. Come on and worship him now, now. Come on, keep pressing in. Come on, keep pressing in. Hey, yeah. I see many of you on the floor. I see many of you on your knees just crying out and travailing. Don't stop. Don't stop. He's imparting in you right now. Don't stop. Don't stop. Hey. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Don't stop. For this is the day of change, says God. This is the day that I have spoke of. For I have told you that I will make adjustments, that I was shifting things. This is the day of that change. This is the day of the shifting. This is the day of the adjustments. Now God says, make yourself ready for the great catch. Make yourself ready for the great move. For I'm seeing right now moving trucks. I'm seeing right now moving trucks. And God says, make ready now. Get yourself ready to move. For you are not going backwards, but you are moving forward, says God. For the Lord says, this is the day now, now. For you will walk in my promise. You will walk in my perform word. Lift up your eyes now and see. Lift up your eyes now and see. For this is the day, says the Spirit of the living God. Wipe your eyes. Wash your face. Get ready. Wake up now. This is not a dream. For this is a reality, says God. For the Spirit of God said, Things are changing. Things are shifting. Things are adjusting. And I said it once, said God, and I will say it again, that the scales have shifted on the behalf of my people. The scales have turned. The scales have moved. The scales now are in favor, or in the favor of my people. So get ready for the great catch. 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 He says, what I'm about to do in you, what I'm about to release into you, what is about to show up at your house, what is right now on its way to be delivered to your house, is something that man cannot give you. It's something that is something even greater. For you have sown much. And God says that now I pour into you, for I have seen the motivation. I have seen the heart. And the Spirit of Living God says that now is the time that I will beautify my house. He said, do you not realize that you are my house and you are my church? For this is the day that I shall beautify my house. This is the day that I shall beautify the city. This is the day that I will beautify my house, my chosen people. Make yourself ready. Make yourself ready. Make yourself ready. For the great catch. Make yourself ready. Make yourself ready. I told you last time that we were together when we were doing a prophetic worship, that I saw the Lord, I saw open heaven, and I saw the Lord shaking a bag. And the things that were coming out of the bag was the best things, that God was shaking out the best on the earth. And it was for his people. There are open heavens now, and it has not closed. Open heavens in 2011. No, it's not a slogan, but it is a prophetic theme. It is a prophetic declaration. God is shaking his best out on the earth. Now, if you would just receive it. Receive the best. I mentioned my friend Mark Kenny. He was singing this song. He said, don't settle for less, but receive the best. And I'm telling you, today is the day that you receive the best. Shakelela baba. Today is the day that you receive the best. Now, if you receive that, you will see it. Today is the day that you receive the best. Today is the day that you see. That you see and receive the payment of your praise. I hope you just heard what I said. Today is the day that you receive payment from your praise. Today is the day that you see payment, payment from your praise. Oh, today is the day that you receive payment. from your praise. See, I want you to understand that your praise, the years that you were releasing a praise to God, it was not in vain. But this is the day that you receive payment from your praise. Oh, my. Today is the day that you receive payment from your praise. I'm talking about those times where it was not popular. I'm talking about those times where you did not feel like giving God or releasing a praise to God. I'm talking about those times when there were things that were happening and it seemed like praising God was not appropriate. I'm telling you today, God says that you're going to receive payment for that. Because, see, many of you have been questioning or have been questioned by others. How can you praise God through all this mess? How can you praise God and still nothing has changed? You have gone through weeks and months and years praising God and have not seen a direct change. And God says, today is the day that you receive payment from your praise. I'm just hearing this from the Lord, so much from the Lord right now. See, you know, and this is encouraging because you know, many of you have had people tell you that cannot happen. That cannot happen without you doing this, without you doing X, Y, and Z. Something like that could never happen. Just because you declaring it. Just because you were jumping around and, you know, you were declaring, yeah, God, I believe. Just because you were doing it, that don't mean it's going to happen. Come on, it takes work. It takes a plan. You need to figure this out. You know, that ain't gonna happen. You heard so much of that. But yet, in the midst of all of that negativity, you continue to give God what belonged to Him. Can I tell you what I see right now? Because I see many of you walking into new homes and the payment has already been made. See, you got to understand something. You wasn't just making noise during that time and season. You wasn't just making noise, okay? But you were literally putting a down payment on the promises of God. You were putting a down payment on that house, on that land, on that car, on that church. Okay? You were putting a down payment on that inheritance. I'm trying to give you a picture here that when God, there were certain moments where God was saying, He gave you a direct command that He said, I want you to praise me. I want you to exalt my name. You know, you have been in services where the command from God came to shout or to release your word. You weren't just making noise. You were literally putting a down payment. Oh God, thank you, Lord. Praise. You know what? Praise. How can I put this? Praise is the cash of heaven. And you were putting a down payment on the things that God has promised. See, when we praise God, when we release out ourselves, get a sacrifice of praise, okay? to God, as the Bible said, from the fruit of our lips. What happens now? Those are seeds. Okay? Those are seeds going forth. And so many of you are going to be, I'm telling you, I hear this from the Lord. Many of us are going to begin to walk into some things, walk into some places and opportunities. All right? All because of our praise. This is a direct result of our praise. Many of you are going to walk into some new home that you know that you did not have the money for, that you know that your credit said that disqualified you to get in this house, okay, or getting this particular land. All right, it just totally disqualified you. You couldn't even get it with the place where you're in right now. And financially, and you're going to begin to walk into the place. You're going to begin to walk into some positions that you didn't even have the degrees, all right, for that position. But you're going to walk in there as a direct result of your praise. Many of you are going to walk in a financial greatness, but I mean you're going to be walking in so much wealth on the earth here as a result of your praise. And let me just say this, that the wealth that you are going to walk in, it's going to put it's going to put the Donald Trumps and the Bill Gates to shame. Seriously. The wealth that you're going to walk in, I mean, it's going to be even greater. Excuse me. It's going to be even greater than that. And many are going to come ask you, man, what was your seed? What'd you do? You know, how'd you plan for this? what was your financial scheme? Where did you invest? See, there are going to be individuals who are going to be looking at this and asking these questions, trying to figure out how did you attain these things, how did you attain these things by earthly view or earthly ways, or what kind of earthly strategy were you using to attain this? Not realizing that this thing didn't come by me, you know, investing in the stock market or investing here, investing there. But I made an investment into the kingdom of God with my praise. I see it. The best. God is shaking the best on the earth. As a matter of fact, the Lord said this to me, that he was shaking the best. He was shaking on 1-11-11. You remember we did the broadcast on 1-11-11. He was shaking his best on the earth then. The word of the Lord to us was, as the rain and the snow falls and waters the ground, so shall my word be. It will not return unto you void, but it will accomplish. It will accomplish the very thing it was sent to do. It will accomplish its assignment, its purpose. It cannot return to God empty-handed. Okay, and so he said that when it was snowing on 1-11-11, or I believe it was either the day before or that particular day, he said, that is my performed word. He said, it is falling to the earth. God says, I was shaking my best onto the earth. That's what he said. He said, I was shaking my best onto the earth. So it wasn't something that was going to happen. It was something that was happening right now. So the very thing that God has said to us, the words that he said to us, what we saw is what he was going to perform. And he says that he said that the very thing that he was releasing now, it's already here. So now we called it forth now to come to us, to be delivered to us, to be placed into our hands. Watch this now. So now we are in expectation. We're looking. We're waiting for the delivery. We're looking for a package. We're looking for the very thing that God has released. See, it's already here. It just needs to be delivered. You got to see it. I heard it like this before. Say what you see so you can see what you said. Say what you see so you can see what you said. That's why the Lord said today, we have prayed enough. We have declared enough. Now just release the praise. Just release the praise. Why? Because we're celebrating. We're celebrating for what the Lord has done. We're celebrating for what is coming to us. What is already here, but what is being delivered to us. I was watching a video last night. Bishop Tudor Bismarck. And he shared this story where there was a lady who was a baker, or she was a caterer. And she was doing this out of her home. And so she took the profits from her business and she sold it. She sold it. Okay, she planted the seed. And so anyway, she was in the town in this town at the market, and he said that there was a lady that came up to her and said, she said, "Who are you? What is your name?" She told her name. And so she said, What do you do?" And so she told her what she does and everything. And so the lady said that I was in prayer last night, and the Lord told me to come here. She said, "I was here for 2 hours waiting for someone." She said, "You're the one." She said that I'm getting ready to move, and I have a restaurant. And the Lord wants me to give you this restaurant. Okay? Now, watch this now. Not only she gave her the restaurant, but, excuse me, But the money that was left in the account for the restaurant, she gave that to her as well. So now, this lady now is now able to move into a restaurant that has the chairs, has the tables, has all the appliances in the kitchen, everything that she needs now to continue her business. To be able to do more. All right? And then on top of that, she has money to work with now. Gave it to her. So I'm sharing that to let you know that those things happen and is happening right now. Listen, don't let your reasoning, don't let your logic get in the way of you hearing and receiving the word of the Lord today. I'm telling you, I just see it. Many of us are going to walk into places. What does the word say? The Bible says that he said he has prepared. What the Bible says, eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither has it entered the hearts. Okay, enter the hearts of man, or enter into the hearts of those who, again, the scripture's twisted up, but enter into the hearts of man what God has prepared for those that love him. Now think about that. Think about that now. While this woman
was moving on and doing, walking out the vision of the Lord, walking out the call of God for her life. While she was doing that, God was preparing a place for her, bigger space now, for her to be able to continue to do what she was called to do. Gave her more. What does the word say? He said, I will give you cities, large and beautiful cities that you have not built. I will give you, watch this, houses that you did not feel. Houses filled with good things that you did not feel. Wells that you did not dig. And so here, this young lady received a place that was filled with good things, filled with everything she needed and wanted. I shared this before on our last broadcast, that this is the time where the wine has run out. The wine has run out. The wine that has been made by man runs out. And Jesus has shown up right at the point where everything runs out to bring forth what is needed and wanted. Supernaturally create the things that is needed and is wanted. God is supernaturally creating an opening for you and I. This thing that he's doing this year is something that man cannot do. This is the year that we begin to walk into places and receive things that only come supernaturally. And why is it? So that we can publish his deeds among the nation. You thought that this was going to come by you having to do X, Y, and Z, having to receive this from man. But God says, no, not this year. No, not this year. This year, we're going to begin to see the things that we need and want supernaturally created right before our eyes. This is what happened to those servants when Mary told Jesus, when Mary told them, whatever he tells you to do, go do it. And they filled the water pots and it turned into wine. As they was obedient, it turned into wine. Supernaturally created. So I hear the Spirit of the Living God saying that, you know, the very thing that you were wanting to do, see yourself doing and attaining, you were going about it man's way of, you know, or man's attempt, or man's strategy, using man's strategy to attain, you know, this thing that you see. But the Lord says, remember, what you see is what I'm going to perform. I am performing my word. What you are seeing, what you have received from the Lord, is what the Lord says, I will perform supernaturally in your life. This is the year for that. This is the year that we see that happening. So listen, I receive that word for myself, for my family. I receive that word for this ministry. There are things right now prepared that have been prepared for New Wind International. We have been believing God for a space. We've been believing God for our own facility. So much in my heart that I want to do. We are right now, you know, as you know, we are about to we launched one of our ministries of New Wind called Moving Forward to Grow. And in February, we're going to be doing a workshop, a worship workshop. And I'm looking, and listen, I bless God for the people that I am connected with that allow me to, you know, use their facility and their ability to be able to do this. I bless them for that. But I'm looking for the day to be able to walk in our own facility, in our own building, and begin to do much, much, much more in our own facility, our own place. I look for that. I receive too many words from too many, for so many individuals saying the same thing. They saw a big church. They saw a large church, you know, which I know the church is the body of people, you know, but but there is a building for us. There is a building for New Wind. There is a facility. And I know many, you know, some people have, you know, received, you know, their building in the usual way, and that's fine. But I just dare to believe God that this is the year that we see our facility, you know, that has been prepared for us. And I believe that we will take hold of it supernaturally. They'll be released into our hands supernaturally. That all we can say, oh man, this was nobody but God. Nobody but God. So I believe that. I believe that for this ministry. I believe this for New Wind. That there is an open heaven over us. There's an open heaven over us. And I believe that for you. I believe that there's so much more. There's so much more. You know, so much more that I want to do. There's some things that I want to do and create and all of that, some visions that I see. I just believe that there is a place for that to happen. To be able to do that. And the same for you. There are dreams and visions on the inside of you that you see. But they're more than that. That is what is God going to perform. That's that thing that's in your heart right now. Is that thing. Is his word that he's going to perform. Hallelujah. So receive this word today from the Lord. Receive this word today from Papa. That this is the day. This is the day that you receive victory. This is the day that you see it come in. My wife and I used to do this a lot when we was in Ohio, where we, you know, we lived in this one neighborhood. We used to see like UPS and FedEx trucks passing by all the time. And every time we would see a UPS truck pass by or come down our street or park, you know, next, you know, like right next to the house or in front of the house, we would always say this: Lord, thank you for our deliveries. Lord, thank you for our deliveries. Lord, thank you for our deliveries. And I see a shift now. Many of you have been getting letters and getting phone calls with negative news and, you know, people saying you need this or, you know, excuse me, you owe this and all this stuff and, you know, and when you gonna do this, you know. And you know, you already know what needs to be done. And you're in this place where you're like, man, God, you know, I want to be free from this. I want to do the right thing. I want a fresh start. You know, but you've been bombarded all this stuff. And God says, that ends. It's a shift. Now you're about to receive calls and notifications of, yeah, we got a package here with your name on it. Mm-hmm. Unexpected checks just showing up in the mailbox. Wasn't even looking for it. And I'm not just talking about one, but multiple. See, before we say, oh, no, that can't happen. Before we say that, now, you know, watch your words. Watch your words. Listen, there have been too many testimonies. Too many testimonies that individuals have encountered that they have, you know, received unexpected gifts from the Lord. So why not you? Why not you? I didn't tell the whole story what Beverly Crawford said, but she said that she was, you know, she walked out. She said she walked out, you know, she was in the store or something, and she walked in her car, and then she walked back to her hotel room, and she, you know, walked her back, you know, got in her hotel room, looked in her purse, and she was saying, you know, I'm looking because I'm next, you know. You know, mine is, you know, my thing is coming next. I'm looking to receive mine. It's you know, it's my turn, you know. I'm next to receive from the Lord. Expectation, man, so powerful. Expectation. So I don't care if you look like a fool. You keep looking out the window. You keep looking in your mailbox. You keep looking at your bank account. You keep, listen, you know, you keep waiting, looking and expecting. You keep doing it. That's expectation. That's expectation. I just believe God today. I just believe that he wants to release things supernaturally. He wants to do things supernaturally. I just believe that. I just believe that with all my heart. I believe God is just doing some things that are not the same. You know, I believe that. I believe the Lord is shaking some things up today. I believe he's doing that because, you know, we have come to the place we have been dependent on man long enough. We have been, you know, putting our trust in our abilities. We've been putting our trust in our jobs, in our careers. That we don't, you know, that some of us, we don't even believe God anymore. Because we have this attitude of, well, you know what? You know, I got this. I got this degree. I got this job. I got this career. You know what I'm saying? Everything is flowing and great, you know. So what do I need to believe God for? Believe God wants to do. He wants us to believe him again. He wants us to dare to believe. He wants us to just dare to believe big things. It's time for us to take dominion. It's time for us to stop, you know, believing for the small and start looking big. Start thinking big and not being intimidated by the big things. It's time for us to take over some malls. You know, we need to, you know, seriously, we need to lose. We need to allow God to deliver us from this intimidation that, you know, when we even look at a mall, we be like, psh, man, what will I do with that? Oh, I can never run that. Oh, I can never own something like that. No. Time for us to start thinking differently. Thinking out of the box. It's time for us to really start doing that. I had an opportunity in Ohio. I'm just talking to you now. I had an opportunity when I was in Ohio to be a part of this church called Living Word Worship Center. And I mentioned to you before, many of you know CJ and Lanita Gall. And many of you that don't know them, you will get a chance to meet them real soon. We're going to have them come to St. Louis and minister here in New Wynn. But their ministry was in the mall. And by the time my wife and I got there, they were in this small space, and I'll never forget. I mean, so many miraculous things were happening in that space. It was just, I mean, we seen people get their teeth filled from the Lord. You know, we've seen people knees healed, eyes healed. Yeah, I mean, just all kind of stuff. A lot of supernatural sign. And then God took us to a bigger space. Many words came across about that mall, about life coming back into the mall. Now watch this now. It was a mall now that seen life, but at that particular time was going downhill. That many were moving out, moving to another part of the town. And we just continued to speak life over that space and life into the grounds. And now, as of this day, right now, someone purchased the mall, remodeled the whole thing, okay? Changed the, you know, repaved the parking lot and all of that. There was a movie theater on the inside, state-of-the-art, you know, equipment. I mean, to look at that mall now to where what it was and to look at it now, it's just amazing. But we were in there. We were in there speaking life. We played a part. We played a part in where that mall is now. Life came back to that mall. And so, but I'll never forget it. You know, my wife and I, we were talking to him. And he said, you know, we needed to be a part of this. We need to see this so that we could dream big. So we can believe for big. Well, you know, why not buy a mall? Mm-hmm. It's amazing to me. I see a lot of I see a lot of buildings. I see a lot of, you know, property, just vacant. You know, there are even some malls that I, you know, seen here in St. Louis. They are just vacant. Now I'm like, oh my gosh, you know, malls. I remember as a teenager. Walking as a teenager, just vacant. And it's time for the church. It's time for the church to rise up and walk in dominion. And say, you know, I'll take that. I'll do something. I got vision. I got vision. I can do something with that. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, it's time for new things. It's time to dream. It's time to release the dream. It's time to be creative now. I encourage you that, you know, if you're, you know, if you're not, if you're unemployed right now, you're not working, and you're, you know, you've been handing in applications and you're just not getting any bites and, you know, you're going through that whole process, I encourage you to tap into the things in your heart, the things that God has birthed in your spirit. I believe that this is a time to create. Now, I'm going to say this. I believe that for most people, that the reason why God has not allowed these individuals to get hired on a particular job, because God wants you to create something. He wants you to start your own. And the very thing that is stopping you is fear. You know, where do I begin? I don't have the money. You know, I know what I want to do, but where, you know, and listen, that's where it starts. It starts with the vision. Okay? It starts with writing the vision. It starts with making it plain so that those who read the vision can run with it. You know what that scripture means out of Habakkuk? You know why it's so necessary to write the vision down? It's because that God, as you write the vision down, God will send people alongside you that know how to do some specific things that you wrote down. You may not be able, you may not know how to do it. You may not have the expertise on that, but God will send people to you and that will walk alongside you that know how to do that very thing and will help you bring it about. That's what that scripture means. He says that's the reason why he said, write it down, make it plain, so that those who read it can run with it. Those who have, those who are skilled and are anointed to do this, they can see themselves in that. Oh, okay, I know how to do it. And they can run with it and take off.